Welcome back to Build Some, and in this video, which is the fifth video in the series on timber framing code, or 1684.2, the Australian standard, I want to have a quick look at ceiling load width, or CLW. So, as you can see up there, it says that the ceiling load width is the contributory width of the ceiling, usually measured horizontally, and imparts ceiling loads to a supporting member. Ceiling load widths shall be used as an input to the span tables for all your hanging beams, counter beams, and strutting and hanging beams. So we need to work out ceiling load widths for those members. Hanging beams, counter beams, and strutting and hanging beams. So here's our ceiling. You can see in this case we've actually got three hangers in this particular roof or ceiling frame. So we have to work out the ceiling load width for those. So ceiling load width is reasonably easy. All it is the span of the room, or the span of ceiling joist that the hanging beam or the beam is going to carry, and you just simply divide that by two. So in this case it's the entire width of the building internally divided by two gives us the ceiling load width at the hanger, which is indicated as A in this case. If we went up to this scenario, where our ceiling joists run all the way through, but we have a supporting wall here, then our span is only what the ceiling joist is going to span, and divide that by two to give us the effective area, or effective width, that the ceiling joist is going to carry. So it's only going to carry from halfway there and halfway out this side. So span 2 divided by 2 will give us the ceiling load width for the hanger at B. And that's it. Ceiling load widths are pretty simple.